Hi, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we are unboxing something really special. This is Flesh and Blood Monarch, and it is first edition as well. Now, before we get started, this is on the website right now. It is a collector's product, so it is a bit higher in price than other Flesh and Blood products are. However, Unlimited is coming out early June, so if you're looking to play or just collect Flesh and Blood, check that one out because it's going to be really cool. And as a player of Flesh and Blood and someone who hasn't opened any first edition Flesh and Blood at all, I am super excited to open this because first edition stuff is really cool, and I'm incredibly excited not just for that but also the stuff that we can find inside. As always, links in the description below for this product that's available on the website right now. Also, if you're interested in playing Flesh and Blood, check out the Blitz decks as well. If you get your hands on those, they are a great starting point. So, let's get into this box. So we got a couple of different pack designs here. One in that kind of brighter gold and one that's slightly darker brown to represent the different factions that are at play in this set, the light and the shadow. So let's get started with our first pack. Of course, we've had a lot of spoilers with this spoiler season leading up to this day. So I've seen a lot of the bits for this amazing looking set. And as usual, we'll be looking out for any majestics, legendaries, or even a fabled fable. So we have Rifted Torment, a Shadow Runeblade action. The fun thing about this set is that we've got additional kind of archetypes, I guess, for the classes that we already have. So Runeblade and Shadow, which goes with the hero later on in this set. So with this one, it is a 2-cost. You may play Rifted Torment from your Banished Zone, and if you do, deal 1 arcane damage to a target hero. It also has the new Blood Debt keyword at the bottom there as well. At the beginning of your end phase, if Rifted Torment is in your Banished Zone, lose a life. So those are things we'll be coming across soon. Some of these I might just pick out the interesting bits. We've got Shadow Brute as well in this set. 1-cost as an additional cost to play the Boneyard Marauder. Banish 3 cards at random from your graveyard. So lots of banishing in this set as well. So we have Rift Bind, another Shadow Runeblade card that also has the Blood Debt ability on it. And as usual with Flesh and Blood, we've got different resource costs in the top as well for all these common cards. Then we have Take Flight, our first Light Warrior action, because there is a Light Warrior named Bolton in this set, or Bolton. So this card has the interesting keyword Charge. So when you charge your hero's soul, you put a card from your hand face up under your hero card that you can only do with certain abilities. And Bolton is really cool in that regard. We have Herald Rebirth, Light Illusionist. Now, Illusionist is the new class in this set. She seems to be able to put spectral auras in front of her to protect her life, which is pretty cool. And this has another interesting keyword on it, Phantasm, where if this card is defended by a non-illusionist attack action card with 6 or more damage, it's destroyed and you close the combat chain immediately. This is a really pretty card, and also something to add on as well is the different borders as well, this gorgeous illusionist border. So we have another Light Warrior action, Express Lightning. As an additional cost to play this, you may charge your hero's soul. And it is 4 damage for 0 cost. That looks pretty good to me. So a generic action. As usual, we have generic cards in the set that will help any class that you are playing. And this is Zealous Belting. While this card, there is a card in your pit zone with damage greater than a Zealous Belting's base damage, Zealous Belting does go again. It's pretty cool. A straight shadow action with our Lunatide Plunderer. If this hits a hero, banish it and up to 1 card from their soul, working really good against those heroes that like to charge their soul. So we have a straight up light action. Impenetrable Belief, with some gorgeous artwork there. And if three or more cards have been put into an opposing hero's banished zone this turn, Impenetrable Belief gains +2 defense while defending. Beautiful. We have Adrenaline Rush. When you play Adrenaline Rush, if you have less life than opposing hero, it gains 3 damage. Really cool card. Again, with that beautiful artwork. We have Memorial Ground, a generic instant that costs 0, and puts target attack action card with cost 2 or less from your graveyard on top of your deck. Some good recovery there. Then we have Bounding Demigon. Now this is a very beautiful. There's some very subtle foiling on this card. You can slightly see it, which is very, very pretty. Again, it also has that blood debt keyword. Let's separate you out because it's shiny. Then we have Aether Ironweave. You can destroy this to gain 2 resources. Activate this ability only if you've played an attack action card. Add a non-attack action card this turn and go again with the battle 1/2. We have Phantasmify as our first rare. The next attack action card you play this turn is an illusionist in addition to its other class types and gains +3 damage. And Phantasm, and the beautiful word, go again. Our first rare. We have Plow Through as our second rare. Just a straight up warrior action. Your next weapon attack this turn gains +3 damage, and this weapon is defended by an attack action card. It gains +1 damage until the end of the turn. Okay. And then we have our first weapon, Galaxy Black. Once per turn action, spend a resource to attack. If you have played a card from your banished zone this turn, this gains +2 damage until the end of the turn. If Galaxy Black hits a hero, deal 1 arcane damage to that hero as well. That's really awesome. And then on the back of this token, we have Soul Shackle, which is an aura for the Shadow Rune Blade. At the beginning of your action phase, banish the top card of your deck. Let's keep those tokens separate as well. Cool. Also, we are opening this up on this gorgeous Flesh and Blood playmat. We have tons at the store, and as soon as we're able to, we're going to be doing Flesh and Blood events. So if you're located anywhere near Folkestone, we've got tons of playmats, tons of promos to give away. So keep an eye out for when we can do those events. Should be within the next few months or so. So we've got the token Spectral Shield, something that the Illusionist would do good having, and Iris of Reality, the Illusionist's weapon. During your action phase, Illusionist auras you control are weapons with 4 damage, and once per turn action, spend 3 resources to attack and go again. That's really cool. Let's check you over there and look through this pack. So we have Dread Screamer, Rip Through Reality, Hungering Slaughter Beast, Herald of Protection, very beautiful card. Cross the Line, Herald of Ravages, Rising Solar Tide, Blinding Beam, Rally the Rearguard, Frontline Scout, Warmonger's Recital, and a beautiful foil, Courageous Steel Hand. If you've charged this turn, target attack gains +2. That's not even bad. Not even bad. We have Stubby Hammerers as our generic equipment. Battlefield Blitz as our rare. If you've charged this turn, Battlefield Blitz gains go again. It's cool. And we have another rare, Unhallowed Rites. If you've played a non-attack action this turn, you may play it from your banished zone. You may put a non-attack action card with blood debt from your graveyard on the bottom of your deck. Okay, so on the token, we have our first hero, Prism, the young version of her. Once per turn instant, spend 2 resources, banish a card from Prism's soul, and create a Spectral Shield token, which we saw before. Pretty awesome. And then we have the gigantic, or as some would say, normal version of her, Prism, Sculptor of Arc Light, which is exactly the same, other than double the amount of health and used in Constructed. Okay, so we have Smash with Big Tree, Brute Action. Just straight up 6 damage for that yellow one. Rifted Torment again, Hungering Slaughter Beast, Express Lightning, Enigma Chimera. That's 2 cost, Phantasm, and 8 damage. Courageous Steel Hand. Ghostly Visit, a very pretty card. I do like that card art. Ray of Hope, again, really like that art because it is the cover art for the box, or at least half of it anyway. Nice. We have Spew Shadow, Surging Militia, and Lunatide Plunderer. And a beautiful Glisten Rare Foil. Distribute up to 4 plus 1 counters among any number of weapons you control. At the beginning of your end phase, remove all plus 1 counters from weapons you control. Nice. We have Ironhide Gauntlet, another rare Battlefield Blitz, and another rare Captain's Call. So, 0 cost, choose one. The next action card with cost 2 or less, you play this turn, gains plus 2 damage. Or the next attack action card with cost 2 or less, you play this turn, gains go again. And then you get go again. That's a really versatile card. I like it. Okay, so we have another weapon for the brutes, the Ravenous Meat Axe. Once per turn action, spend 2 resources to attack. Whenever you attack with this card, draw a card, then discard a random card. If a card with 6 or more damage is discarded this way, this card gains plus 2 damage until the end of the turn, and it starts with 3. And then on the back, we have Levia, the Shadow Brute Hero, or at least the young version of her. So, if a card with 6 or more damage has been put into your banished zone this turn, cards you own lose blood debt during the end phase. So, excited to play these new heroes. So we have Hungering Slaughter Beast again, Seeds of Agony, a card art that is incredibly pretty. Smash with Big Tree, Herald of Rebirth, War Tune Herald, Cross the Line, Rally the Rear Guard, War Monger's Recital, Brandish, and Illuminate, Zealous Belting, and a Foil Boneyard Marauder. And Aether Ironweave once again. Invigorating Light as our rare. When you play Invigorating Light, if there are no cards in your hero soul, put it into your hero soul when the combat chain closes. And we also have Dusk Path Pilgrimage. Your next weapon attack this turn gains plus 1. And if this hits, you may attack an additional time with this weapon this turn. But you must have an action point in order to do so. That's cool. That's helpful. That might be helpful to Dorinthia, to be fair. We have the Iris of Reality once more. And on the back, Prism again. Bounding Demigon. Smash with Big Tree. Piercing Shadow Vice. Another Shadow Runeblade card. Herald of Ravages. Take Flight. Wartune Herald. Overload. A generic action that looks very much like a Mechanologist card. Dominate. And if it hits, it gains go again. Okay, interesting. Illuminate, Memorial Ground, generic instant again. Blood Tribute, look at that art. Man, that's cool. And you get to op 3 and then manage the top card of your deck. That is a cool card. Surging Militia. And Seeds of Agony in foil. Ooh, I do like that. That's nice. We have Halo of Illumination, a light equipment for the head. Instant, spend a resource, destroy this, and then put a card from your hand into your hero's soul, and if it's a light card, draw a card. That sounds pretty decent. And then Spell Void 2 as well. Phantasmify, once again, a rare. And Howl from Beyond, again, more beautiful art. We have Seeds of Agony, Dread Screamer. There's some really insane art in this. Rip Through Reality, Herald of Ravages, Engulfing Light, Speeds of Surreality, Lunatide Plunderer. Look at that board art. It's stunning. Surging Militia, Impenetrable Belief, Talisman of Dowsing. Okay, so it's an item, go again, and Spell Void 1. That's not even that bad. That's cool. Zealous Belting, and Rip Through Reality in foil. We have Dreamweavers, Illusionist Equipment for the Armed. Destroy this, the next Illusionist attack action card you play this turn loses and can't gain Phantasm. Which is pretty cool, getting rid of that downside from Phantasm as a keyword. And then Spell Void 1. Glisten as our first rare, and Arclight Sentinel as our Majestic, our first Majestic. So this is Prism specialization. I think I know what I'm going to build. It's 6 resources. You can only have it in your deck if your hero is Prism. And if Arclight Sentinel is in the arena when an opponent announces an attack, they must choose this as the target of the attack. It also has Spectra, so it can be attacked. And when it becomes the target of an attack, it's destroyed and the combat chain closes. Okay, so we get a first look at our Light Warrior hero in this set, Bolton. If you've charged this turn, attacks you control have +1 damage while defended by an attack action card. Then an attack reaction, banish a card from Bolton's soul. Target attack with damage greater than its base damage gains go again. That's pretty swish. Then we have a big Sir Bolton, Breaker of Dawn, who has the same thing, slightly different art, and more health. Awesome. So we have Deadwood Rumbler. Riftbind, look at that. So good. Unworldly Bellow. Second Swing. Herald of Rebirth. Cross the Line. Blinding Beam. Rising Solar Tide. Stony Wootenhog. Love that. Seek Enlightenment. Illuminate. And Spears of Surreality as our foil illusionist common card. We have some Ironhide Legs, Herald of Judgment as a rare, and a Vexing Malice as our second rare. Deal 2 arcane damage. And Adrenaline Rush as our common foil. Very pretty. Stubby Hammerers, Endless Moor as our first rare, and a second majestic Raiden Duskbane. Now I'm going to go ahead and assume that that's Bolton's sword, but that is a very pretty card. Once per turn, action, 0 cost, attack. If you've charged this turn, this card gains +3 damage. Awesome. Awesome sword. Smash with Big Tree and foil. Nice. Time Skippers. New equipment. Action. 3 resources. Destroy it and get 2 action points. Cool. Dimensional Gateway as our first rare. Opt 1. Then reveal top card of your deck. If it's a Rune Blade card, deal 1 arcane damage to each opposing hero. If it's a shadow card, you may banish it. Okay. And Prismatic Shield for the Illusionist. Create 3 Spectral Shield tokens. Great. Pound for pound. Look at that art. Love that. 2 big beefy boys just punching each other. Oof. I love how that art just kind of almost blends in with the border as well. Dimensional Gateway in foil. As the rare as well. Wow, nice one. We have Ironhide Helm. Phantasmify, another illusionist Phantasmify. And Seek Horizon. Okay, a new weapon token. So for the warrior, it's an axe, one-handed. Hatchet of the Mind, once per turn action. Costs 1 resource, attack. Whenever you attack with Hatchet of the Mind, if Hatchet of the Body was the last attack this turn, this card gains +1 damage until the end of turn. Ooh, Yinti Yanti, look at that. Oh. While Yinti Yanti is attacking, you control Nora, it's got +1 damage. While Yinti Yanti is defending and you control Nora, it has +1 defense. Nice versatile card. Halo of Illumination. That's a foil. Ooh. As a foil, as a cold foil, that is beautiful. I didn't even notice it was a foil. That's how good it was. No, that's really pretty. Aether Ironweave, Phantasmify again, and another majestic, another beautiful majestic, Tome of Torment. You may play Tome of Torment from your banished zone. Draw a card and Blood Debt. And it's 0 cost. That is a gorgeous card. Let's get another sleeve going. We have Hatchet of the Body, opposite Hatchet of the Mind. Whenever you attack with this card, if the Hatchet of the Mind was the last attack this turn, this card gains plus one damage till the end of the turn. Zealous Belting is our common foil. Hooves of the Shadow Beast. That's a pretty card. Let's check you. Nope, not there. There. Whenever a card with 6 or more damage is put into your banished zone, you may destroy this card if you do gain an action point. And it's got Battle Worn as well. Interesting. Tremor of Eärathel. Or Eärathel. If a card has been put into your banished zone this turn, this card gets plus 2 damage. Cool. So our next rare, we have Outmuscle. While Outmuscle isn't defended by a card with equal or greater damage, it has go again. That's nice. I like that a lot. And just to see it, we have Levia's proper adult form Shadowborn Abomination, which is very awesome. Smash with Big Tree again. It's our foil. Valiant Thrust. If you charge this turn, this card gains plus 3 damage. That's really nice. And Endless Maw, which we've already seen, I believe. Nice. Okay, so now we've got our first look at Chain, the Shadow Runeblade hero. Once per turn action, create a Soul Shackle token, which we have seen before. Your next Runeblade or Shadow action this turn gains go again, go again. Nice. And we have Big Chain on the back. Foil Frontline Scout. Plow Through, which we've seen before, I think. And Writhing Beast Hulk. As an additional cost to play this, banish 3 random cards from your graveyard. If a card with 6 or more damage is banished this way, this card gains Dominate, and it also has a Blood Debt. Writhing Beast Hulk as a rare in foil. Nice one. Convulsion from the Bellows of Hell as one of our rares. I think we've seen it before. That's very pretty. And another majestic, we have the amazingly named Phantasmaclasm. Look at the defending hero's hand and choose a card. They put it at the bottom of their deck, then draw a card. And it has Phantasm, and it has 9 damage and costs 3. The Illusionist is awesome. Foil Unworldly Bellow, Halo of Illumination, Endless Maw once more, and V of the Vanguard, a rare that we have not seen. Bolton Specialization though, which is cool, and as an additional cost to play this card, you may charge your hero soul any number of times. Attacks you control on this combat chain gain plus 1 damage for each light card charged this way. That is awesome. We have foil, rare Tremor of Eärathel. We have Pulping as another rare, as a brute action. Draw a card, then discard a random card. If a card with 6 or more damage is discarded this way, this card gains Dominate. While this card is defended by less than 2 non-equipment cards, it has go again. And Plow Through once more. We have the Subtle Foil Memorial Ground. Captain's Call once again, and Duskpath Pilgrimage again. Do we have this? Yeah, I think we do. Hungering Slaughter Beast with that foil. Ooh, Ebon Fold. So that is a shadow equipment and it's awesome. Instant, cost of resource, destroy this card, banish card from your hand, and if it's a shadow card, draw a card, and spell Void 2. Dimensional Gateway again, and Captain's Call, and Laborble. So it's the first one of these tokens we've got. It is Blasphemet, the Soul Harvester. It is an ally, the first ally we've seen. They can be attacked and can't be defended with damage. They are destroyed when they have taken damage equal to their health. And at the end of the turn, you heal all damage dealt to this card. Once per turn, action costs 0 and is an attack for 6 down here. Whenever Blasphemet attacks, you may banish a shadow card from your hand. If you do, you may banish a card from the defending hero's soul. This awesome new mechanic that they have added in here. And then on the back we have Ursa, the Soul Reaper, another ally, which has, while this is attacking a hero with one more card in their soul, this attack has go again. Another Writhing Beast Hulk in foil. Unfold once more, Glisten again, and Captain's Call once again. We have Spill Blood, a majestic foil. Oof. Axes you control get +2 damage and dominate until the end of the turn. That is some gorgeous artwork. Let's get you into a sleeve, my dude. That's a very pretty card. We also have Gallantry Gold, an equipment that we haven't seen for the arms. As a cost, a resource, destroy this card. Your weapon attack gains +1 damage and go again. Cool. Battle Worn 1. We have Rise Above, a gorgeous rare. You may put a card from your hand on top of your deck rather than pay this card's cost, which is interesting. And another majestic, a double majestic pack, Sonata Arcanix for the Runeblade. Reveal the top X +3 cards of your deck. For each non-attack action card revealed this way, put an attack action card revealed this way into your hand. Deal arcane damage to target hero equal to the number of cards put into your hand this way. Shuffle your deck and banish this card and go again. Sonata Arcanix. So the X cost here, yeah, is just double that of there, which makes sense. You know, I should have probably realized that, but I think it's, yeah, it's just probably the first card I've ever seen with like two X's in the corner. That looks just kind of interesting. But yeah, really cool card, and another majestic to add to the pile. We have Spears of Surreality as our foil. Seek Horizon, as an additional cost to play this card. You may put a card from your hand on top of your deck, and if you do, this card gains go again. Nice. Big fan of that card. And Tremor of Iriathul again. Frontline Scouts are called. As our common foil, ooh, Blood Drop Brocade, generic equipment. Instant, destroy this card, gain 1 resource. Activate this ability only if you have dealt or been dealt damage this turn. Okay. Cool, could be versatile. Dusk Path Pilgrimage again. And Nourishing Emptiness as another majestic. It's a generic action, it costs 2, has insanely good art. And while there are no attack action cards in your graveyard, this card has dominate. And if this hits, your hero gets +1 hand size until the end of the turn. That is a cool card, especially in Blitz. That could be pretty good. It's got 6 damage as well. Nice one. Chuck you in a sleeve. And this is now our final pack. Graveling Growl. Bounding Demigon. Unworldly Bellow. Enigma Chimera. Second Swing. Herald of Tenacity. Memorial Ground, Stony Wootenhog, Yinti Yanti, Seek Enlightenment, Overload, Second Swing in that foiling, Ironhide Plates, Writhing Beast Hulk, and finally Soul Harvest, a rare that we haven't had yet, so that's pretty cool. So it's Levia Specialization. Costs 6, And as an additional cost to play this card, banish 6 cards from your graveyard. It gains +1 damage for each card with blood that banished this way. If Soul Harvest hits hero, banish all cards from their soul and they lose health equal to the number of cards banished this way. Awesome. Awesomely good against those light people wanting to charge. And that is it. That is our haul from this box. A ton of Majestics. No Legendaries, unfortunately, but that's okay. A load of interesting cards. A load of light cards that I think I might be in for using in Blitz. The Illusionist stuff looks really cool. And yeah, that's what you could get in this box. Hopefully you'll get better pulls. But as we said at the beginning of this video, this is a first edition box. This is a collector's product, really, for people who like to have the slightly more expensive stuff. If you are looking to play Flesh and Blood, check this one out. Check out the Blitz decks. But most importantly, check out the Unlimited set that's going to be coming out in early June. We don't have it on the website right now, or at least it's out of stock currently, because we haven't put the stock up yet. But as soon as we do, we should have a ton of it. So make sure you check that out. Check out Flesh and Blood. It's a really cool game. I really like it a lot. And if you're in the local Folkestone area, as soon as we're able to, we're going to be starting to do events, because we've got a ton of stuff that we want to give. And I'm super excited about it. So that's it from me. I've been John of Chaos Cards, and I will see you next time.